Inner Traditions Audio presents 7 Reasons to Believe in the Afterlife, A Doctor Reviews the Case for Consciousness After Death, by Jean-Jacques Charbonier, M.D., read by Robin Douglas. Foreword. Take note. This book is a public utility venture. In 10 or 15 years, what Dr. Charbonier is affirming today, namely the survival of consciousness after death, will probably seem like the most ordinary thing in the world. But today, he is alone in having the courage to affirm this with great clarity, using science as his foundation. And this he has done in spite of virulent and sometimes personal attacks directed at him from materialists and skeptics of all persuasions. Writing in a lively, easy-to-read style and taking into account the latest scientific discoveries, J.J. Charbonier shows us just how important it is to reconsider our point of view about death. In this study, you will learn that the best reason for believing in the hereafter arises from the fact that the hypothesis of life after death is now much more valid than the opposite materialist view that affirms that after death there is nothing. The good doctor bases his position on data collected from numerous scientific studies carried out over the last 35 years. Just in the case of Pamela Reynolds alone, as recounted in the next chapter, and the way in which Jean-Jacques Charbonier refutes the unfounded materialist objections to it, demonstrates his position. Her case proves all by itself that consciousness is independent of the brain and survives the death of the brain. Dr. Charbonnier's book might well have borrowed its title, The End of Materialism, from a book by the scientist Charles Tart. One need only look at the facts that have been brought to light. Doubt is no longer in the picture, and materialism has lost the debate. There is very definitely a life of consciousness that continues after the death of the body. My colleague suggests that the expression, quote-unquote, experience of provisional death would be an improvement over, quote-unquote, near-death experience, NDE. As he puts it so well, quote, someone whose heart stops is not near death, or on the borders of death, or in a state of imminent death. He is already dead, and may have been dead for quite a few minutes. Some people claim, erroneously in my view, that NDE is like being in the departure lounge of an airport. You haven't really gotten on the plane, and you don't really know the destination. Rather than that, during an NDE, everything seems to indicate that we do take the plane, that we really do arrive in the land of the dead. But we come back because we were lucky enough to have a return ticket, unlike the usual irreversible death. Unquote. In this practical manual, we really are talking about death and what happens after life on Earth. What you have in your hands is something like a roadmap for the afterlife, a way of preparing yourself for your own passing, or helping to prepare those close to you for theirs, so that the person concerned is in a position to take advantage of this final journey. Individuals who have lived through this contact with death are quick to say that what happened to them is more real than reality, and that any doubts about the existence of the hereafter is for them pointless. They no longer fear death, and their spiritual transformation in the years following their experience is in itself a major argument supporting the authenticity of their contact with another reality. As Professor Kenneth Ring has shown, the long-term, very positive impact of an NDE on the existence of those who have been through one can be partially transmitted like a sort of positive virus to those who read the accounts of these experiencers. In the study that you now have in your hands, I believe you will catch this virus, and it will change your life. In the long term, it brings laughter, love, and joy to everyday life. And in facing life, it is easier to relax when you know that it will continue after the death of the body. Only that which is essential, our consciousness, our knowledge, our capacity to love, and our loving connections is carried over into the hereafter. I will conclude this foreword by giving you my heartfelt response, which arose just after I finished reading this book, and which I immediately expressed in a note to Dr. Charbonnier. Quote, "Dear colleague, I have just finished reading your book. How lively, clear, and convincing it is! I am sure it will become a reference work that will open minds and touch hearts in the public at large. With what clarity you set forth the facts, as well as all those beautiful first-hand accounts, and with what skill you unravel the arguments of our materialist detractors, so predictable in their naive unseeingness. Bravo, and thank you for all of this. Death's lessons teach us how to live better." Unquote. Olivier Chambon, M.D. Olivier Chambon has been a psychiatrist and psychotherapist for more than 20 years, and is a pioneer of behavioral and cognitive methods of care for chronically psychotic patients. In France, he is responsible for co-creating the university degree known as integrative psychotherapy. Trained in shamanism and in many disciplines of psychotherapy, he is the author of La Médecine Psychédélique, Psychedelic Medicine, and the co-author with Laurent Hugli of La Chamane et Lucie, The Shaman and the Shrink. Preface. People often ask me, "Doctor, you said that you are convinced of the existence of the hereafter. Do you have at least one good reason you can give to back that up?" Or, "I know you have written several books on life after this life. I'm looking for a book that isn't full of medical terminology and is not too hard to read, and which I can give to someone who is very open to all these things but hasn't read anything about them. What title would you advise?" These frequently asked questions led me to write this book. I was looking for a text that would be as simple and concise as possible. I wanted it to provide answers for an uninitiated readership, to classic questions from a novice, and to be a book that could also answer questions from most of the skeptics and materialist detractors who consistently assail me through the internet and the media. I have sought out the best arguments to support the existence of a hereafter, and I have found 7 of them, 7 phenomena that are unfortunately quite unknown, disputed by many people, and yet irrefutable. 7 stunning proofs that are difficult to counter. For each of them, I have provided space for their detractors to speak so that I may expose the weakness of their reasoning, and show that such reasoning easily crumbles in the face of the logic of a rigorous and objective analysis. Belief in a hereafter transforms life. Material values fade and are no longer a priority. Fear of death disappears. Happiness becomes synonymous with love and spirituality, and because of this, it seems much more accessible. In this lower world dominated by money, however, we are egotistically driven to desire to accumulate material riches while disregarding everything else. And certainly it is because of this that there are so many unhappy people in our Western society. We no longer talk to each other in depth, and meditation is considered a waste of time. It seems indeed to be atypical in this materialistic culture to value giving love to others by taking full advantage of the fortuitous instances of a random encounter, or at any particular moment indulge in a walk in nature, or seize an opportunity to have a prolonged conversation with a friend or a stranger whom we happen to run into by chance. A belief in the hereafter is capable of shifting this paradigm, for, as we shall see, a transcendent modification related to a belief in the hereafter takes place in 18% of the people who have a heart attack, and in all people who have a sincere, real faith in God. Belief in a hereafter also has the advantage of improving health. In fact, the positive effect of faith and prayer on sickness has attracted the attention of numerous physicians. A survey published in the November 10, 2003 issue of Newsweek reveal that a faith in God strengthens morale and promotes an easier and quicker return to good health after a serious illness. In the same study, it was found that 72% of Americans think that prayer helps one to heal better by fostering an early recovery. Work conducted at Rush University in Chicago, as well as research at the University of Michigan, showed that depression and psychosomatic illness linked to stress occurred less frequently in believers, and the mortality rate of young adults was reduced by 25% in those who believed in life after death. Duke University in North Carolina determined that this same rate decreased 30% in heart patients in the year after a serious operation if these patients practiced prayer. These scientific studies only confirm what many of us have believed for years. Belief in the existence of a hereafter provides a greater resiliency and buoyancy in the face of life's challenges, and at the same time, diminishes the serious physical repercussions connected with stress, anxiety, and fear. I invite you now to travel with me on this journey to the other side. It may change the way you view all that you have come to know thus far. Note to the listener: the accounts contained in this book are authentic. They have been personally addressed to me in writing or confided to me in interviews. At the request of certain individuals, however, I have sometimes used fictitious identities and removed any material that might identify the persons concerned. In providing these accounts, I had to limit myself to extracts from the correspondence I received. If, after finishing this book, you liked it, please don't shelve it in your library where it will sleep. Instead, give it away. Among your acquaintances, relatives, friends, and why not, even your enemies, choose the one person who seems the most skeptical about the existence of the hereafter and give it to him or her as a gift. Write a sentence or two on the first page as a dedication, with a date and your signature below it. Then, just wait. If you have any news from your unlikely reader/listener in the following days, weeks, or months, please write to me. I collect all sorts of reactions to add to my personal statistics and in preparation for my next book. May this plea in favor of a hereafter open doors toward real serenity and better health, in spite of the sometimes cruel and painful moments of life.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.